What down, family? It's your boy SNTV. Back at y'all with another Chirac Street Legends. And this episode is going to be about none other than Pac-Man, a.k.a. Lero, a.k.a. the originator of drill.
We getting money, man. Breaking the 100 grams, shaking the 100, so 11 for the 100, fam. I'm on the line with a desert in the other hand, a rubber band strapped to a stack off the bundles, man. I'm out early, so a nigga don't like that. Pack got the Mac on me, homie, come right back. They want gun for me, I'ma let them guns spray. Hiding by the camera, all I probably need is one take. Face shots crack the back of their head. They all dead in the back, getting bread in the back. They better be cool for the lead hit a back. And they back get popped cause they fled through the back, right? I'm on some gutter shit, but niggas on some other shit. Sure, I keep another bitch blowing out a mother shit. They say it's game time, so I get a bang, man. We don't want to change, man. We want to make it rain now.
Man comes from that BNC set or By None Crazy. He also claimed Young Money. They from Snowblock or 64th and Ellis. Pac-Man is originally from the 63rd block of Ellis, which is the next block over. That's in Dro City. Now at the time when Pac-Man was alive, BNC was clicked up with YMB, Saw Block, and Mac Creek, which formed Dro City after Dro died. Before the death of Dro, that area was known as Murder Town.
Man, it's Lero, man, a.k.a. Pac-Man, man. And we on 64th of Ellis, Crenshaw. No, we out here, it's cold, we out here.
Dro, or Sajo, he was a well-loved member from Murder Town. He was killed allegedly by Cranktown September 8th, 2006, making Dro City.
Good kush on Dro, we smoke number Dro, Dro City. On my mama, I gotta show him the tattoo. I gotta show him the Dro City tattoo. On my mama, that fire hook killer, y'all already know what it is. I gotta show the hook. I gotta show the goddamn the Dro City tattoo, man. God damn it. Rest in peace to my nigga Sajo, man. Sajo, man. You gotta get the tattoo, man. Get the tattoo on deck, man. Rest in peace, man. Sajo, aka Droski, man. We getting it, man. 064 BNC, we getting it, man. Come holla at your boy, man.
We getting it, man. Young Money, man. We getting that, man.
You can't be young without the money, man. You can't be young without
the money. But Dro, that was a brother from another man.
Lero was very well known in the streets. He was known in the streets for getting down in the streets, but he was more known for what he did on the music side. Lero would put together these ciphers, and everybody was beginning to see that Lero had bars. As a matter of fact, Lero is the one that's actually credited with being the originator of drill. Lero would put together crazy bars, and after the death of Lero, King Louie would take it to another level, and then Chief Keef would make it worldwide.
What's up with some of that lingo, man? Like, how y'all come up with that shit? Like, that's some East Side shit or what, man?
Man, shit, man. We've been setting trends and doing the lingo for years, bro. This shit, I'm telling you, G, we've been doing this shit for over 10 years. Any motherfucker that's into this whole drill shit from Chicago, this whole music shit, I ain't gonna lie to you. My little brother, Louie, and my brother, Pac, R.I.P., rest in peace, Pac laid the drill lick down. Little bro, Louie just took it and kept that shit alive and just went crazy with it. That drill shit come from us, though. Ain't no doubt about it.
Like, yeah, for real?
The coupe looking like a Sunday, a chocolate Maserati. Butter, vanilla, guts, valet, parking it at the party. Yo, bitch on my heel, she was jocking me in the lobby. See, the Maury crocodile's pocket watching like she gon' rob me. I swipe for a room, penthouse, we at the W. The bitch had your name on the neck, I know my stomach too. I said to myself, I know this Vic ain't wifing her. Got off a pill and did the Dick Van Dyke with her. That means she had another bitch helping the bitch slurp it up. Made her drink the dick till the bitch had to burp it up. B shit, catch me over east of the streets, kid. With the black 740 cap, ooh, with the kick back. Hey, if I'm blowing, then I'm knocking you down. Make his whole block drop like the domino effect. Run up in the spot, smack his mama with the tech. Buckle with the mag if she ain't running me the bag. Fat. and I check the jakes. Bitch, I ain't got shit, you can check the plates. And when this nigga gets slick, I'ma X his base with more holes in his face than a Pepsi crate. The best of great, the Lex color Texas state is decked with drapes. The feds wanna investigate. But I got property copping them like Monopoly, popping them bitches off, got a profit. I got a lot of these jerk. Get your ass patched on the shirt, casket in the church with a black color hearse. I'm a demon, catch a boy shopping up a Neiman. Marcus, I'm a marksman, told the locker with the beam, man. Spot his ass, got his ass, pop his ass, drop his ass. Treat him like the Blackhawk skates, he in the hockey bag. And I stay popping tags, I just might cop the jag to move the heavyweight around the state like them boxing guys. Yeah.
One of the major reasons why Pac-Man is credited with being a pioneer of the drill scene is because the nature of drill is actually doing what you're rapping about. And not only did everybody like Pac-Man, but Pac-Man was somebody that the streets could vouch for. Pac-Man would eventually take his talents from the streets to the studio, as he would drop a song with L.E.P. Bogus Boy G-Count called Street Money.
Give me that street money, street money.
This would place Pac-Man on the radar, and he would begin to record more music. Pac-Man was also on a mission. He would become fed up with losing his loved ones, and he would begin to advocate for peace. He would get with certain community leaders, and he would start doing events in the name of peace. Pac-Man was only 25, but he was maturing. He was starting to realize that the streets was no way out. But little did he know, it was already too late.
Rapping this Woodline Battle on Wax for Peace, man, with my big homie, man. Got my little homie out here, man. We on 64 for Ellis Crenshaw. You know, we out here, it's cold. We out here though, man. Hey, I tell him, shit real. I know how bagging the whole strip feel. Popping out reckless and clapping it to the clip spiel. You can get the tech of the Mac with the no kick steel. Talking out the side of your neck to get your shit peeled back. And I'm backing the fact. I got my bitch wheels blowing out the back of the legs. You feel the wind chill. Suicide doze in the holes, get the tip drill. 66 sick, got them spinning like a windmill. Ellen. That's what the streets should say, but I'm the type of nigga gotta keep the K. On deck, online, one call away, oh, with a 30 and a 40 and a pond of spray. I get away, the dicks can't pat me down. All you hear is Motorola's going in and out the town. Suspect fleeing, we gon' block him off the other side. Fuck, he gotta wait, we gon' catch his ass another time. But you the type of guy that'll run and go dip, cause you don't wanna toast shit. Might get smacked in the mouth with a clip and come out the next day putting ice on the shit. You a vic, and now I'll pipe you down. I had your bitch on the strip trying to wipe you down. With your head in our lap trying to fight them rounds. Got him throwing up blood like he's Su-Wu bound, but you a clown. And you don't really want it with me, cause I be dumping this thing with a stuck in the sleeve. So you won't know where it's coming from, you ducking the weave and running with his back smoking like he running to Jesus, huh? Call me Pops, I'm like a daddy to you. I bought you into the shit and I'll bury you too. I bought you most of the shit that you was wearing to school. Bust all in his mama, probably marry her too. Eastside, man, we out here, man. BNC, Joe City, man, we out here, man.
That's all what it day, is. They man. Coming, Jack. They
On
coming.
Monday, June 21st, 2010, at about 1:53 a.m., Pac-Man was chilling in the heart of his hood on 64th and Ingleside. Somehow he was ambushed and he was shot. He was taken to the hospital where he died 2 hours later. Allegedly, Cranktown is who got Leroy also. Some people say that without Pac-Man, there would be no such thing as drill. And some people say that without Pac-Man, we would have never heard of King Louie. I don't know how true that is. But I know that Pac-Man was going hard in the paint. And I feel like a lot of his ops could stand to see that take place. So they had to get rid of him. Before his death, Pac-Man was working on an album called I'm Still Here. Even though he died, a couple other projects were still released. Beast Over East, Diary, Banned From TV, Roll the Carpet Out, and Dro Style, which he also shot a video to.
Every day we get that, hit him with that Jordan.
Can't say for sure what bodies he had, or if he even had any bodies, but he said out of his own mouth that he did have bodies.
I dropped a couple bodies so you know that too spit.
With Pac-Man being gone, King Louis would have to step up. And that's exactly what he would do. He would take that same energy that Pac-Man started off with, and he would use it to blow up. King Louis will become a Chirac street legend with the spirit of Pac-Man. I think that what we can learn from the story of Pac-Man is this. When we seek to change our ways in life, we must also seek to change our environments, people, places, and things that can possibly remind us of that old lifestyle and bring us back to where we once were. Now with Pac-Man, Pac-Man had moved out of the hood. Pac-Man stayed like on 138th. He stayed on Park Avenue. Pac-Man was actually going back to the hood, chilling, when he ended up being killed by the internet being not necessarily a brand new thing, but a new thing in 2010. I don't think that Pac-Man understood that that one video did a lot. A couple of thousand views back in 2010 when the internet wasn't really popping like that was a lot. And I'm pretty sure that once his ops seen that, they probably decided that it was time for Pac-Man to go. Just because you've changed doesn't mean that everybody else has. So that mindset that you have to where you don't want to be in the streets, you don't want to be killing, stealing, selling drugs, and doing all of this shit, it's all good in your mind. And it may help you get to another level as long as you don't hang around those same people and as long as you aren't in those same environments. To the ops, once you part of something, you part of that something for life. This has been the story of Dro City Pac-Man. It's your boy, SCN TV.